Welcome back everyone to theCUBE's live coverage here in Paris, France. I'm John Furrier, your host of theCUBE, the Raise Summit 2025. 2 days of leaders all around the world coming together to talk about the future of AI, future of AI infrastructure, more importantly as agents come in, the continuing growth of the markets now expanding. Obviously theCUBE Global's here, of course with the NYSE Wired, our team there as well, part of theCUBE powers that. We got another co-founder here, president of products at Snowflake, Benoit. Great to see you, CUBE alumni. Yeah. Thanks for coming on.
Yes, great seeing you.
Dave Vellante tends to do all the interviews because he hogs you, so like, I got my shot. We've both been covering data since theCUBE started 16 years ago, the Hadoop wave, we saw that happen there. Just watching Snowflake rise up and just be so successful from day one, it's been a great testament to what you guys have done, so congratulations.
Thank you.
Now the market is going kind of next level. And Snowflake Summit, you guys talked a lot about how you guys are looking at that platform. Give us a taste of what's happened in the past, because we're at the midpoint of the year. Take us through what the first half was like for you guys internally, the company, the customers. We're in a transformative mode. What were some of the key highlights from the first half of the year?
Yeah, so what is great, right, is the, you know, when we started, just to go back a little bit more than half a year ago, when we started Snowflake, it was really to integrate, you know, structured data with semi-structured data. And now it's about unstructured data. It's all, you know, making that data first class in the platform. Mm-hmm. So a lot of our customers, they want to know how to integrate this new type of data. And I said, you know, like structure and semi-structure being on the same roof, you know, unstructured needs also to be part of your full, you know, data assets, because you might join, you know, information which are unstructured data with information which are structured. So it's very important, like Hadoop and data warehouse should have been combined, you know, and that's what, you know, Snowflake did. We really want to do the same thing with unstructured data. So a lot of capabilities have been added to the platform, AI capabilities. The AI is the SQL for this type of data, and of course RAG and search. So a lot of activity on that part. We announced also AISQL. Mm-hmm. So, you know, bringing, elevating SQL to be also the language to query unstructured data. And that's really fascinating because it's more than just a language, it's also the way you get all the performance. You really need to pack a lot of usage to your GPUs. You don't want to leave any idle cycle on your GPUs, right? This is very important, so optimization. A lot of work has been on performance, optimization, cost.
On the SQL side, so you're optimizing infrastructure as part of your product roadmap to make sure that the utilization.
Yes, that's you know, it's part of a data platform is, you know, efficiency, and efficiency translates to cost. So with GPU, it's even more important, right? We, you know, when we started Snowflake, there was no, you know, like with structured data, there is no need for GPUs, but still, you know, CPU cycle is a really important, you know, currency. Mm-hmm. So you have to use every cycle and you know how you vectorize execution. Yeah. So it's the same thing for GPUs.
Yeah.
How you bring data to GPUs, how you do that efficiency, how you overlap the different stage of a pipeline is.
So there's a lot of innovation under the hood going on that you guys are spending time on.
Yes.
It doesn't get the sexy headlines, but it's really the must needed work.
I mean, that's the, you know, it goes, you know, bottom up. You need to have that before you do the sexy thing.
Yeah, so one of the things that I loved about Snowflake, you did combine the data warehouse. You guys really pioneered data cloud, which we covered. But the market of analytics is operationalized, or it's out there.
Yes.
The Gen AI hype came up very, well, Gen AI was not really kind of a thing, but it got hyped up so fast, people confused operational analytics with the magic of generative AI. So as those 2 years have happened, where are you now on the product side saying, okay, there's an intersection between analytics and Gen AI. What's that look like to you? Because now it's starting to get real. You mentioned RAG, you mentioned some of those chatbots and those use cases. But now when agents start to get in there, what's on the roadmap? What needs to happen? What's the sequence of events?
Yes, so AI has three aspects, right? As I said, without AI, there is no unstructured data in the data platform.
Yep.
So AI is really the tool to understand unstructured data and to extract, you know, that information to be able to process it. You know, you talk about search and RAG. That's also very important, right? Yeah. You know, in structured data, you need workloads to search data, right?
Yeah.
So RAG is the equivalent for unstructured data. Now that's why AI is so important for the data platform. Unlike, you know, any other product, right? We need AI for unstructured data. Then there is the part which is more common is how to interact with data in natural language. So how to leverage the AI and the capability of AI to translate and to convert natural language to potentially SQL or natural language to a search query.
Yeah.
And you know, agent is the layer on top of that, which is about, you know, creating very focused, you know, AI product agents, and integrate, you know, many agents, you know, together to perform, you know, complex tasks, and so that's, you know, where the platform is going. One thing which is critical, and maybe you are going to mention about that, is the semantic, you know.
That was
aspect.
My next question. Yeah. So at Snowflake Summit, you announced semantic views.
Yes.
So define what that is and why is it important.
So why it's important is semantic is about not, you know, the definition of data, right? The definition, the cataloging of data is a table and I have columns and these are the name of this object, but it's not the semantic, the understanding. And oftentimes, you know, an analyst or human being will have that in his head, or an application, you know, the complex application have a semantic model embedded in their application. But now if you want AI to replace the human and be able to ask, you know, direct question to the AI needs to have this understanding. So you need to push that inside the platform. So really, modern data platform is one layer, level zero, if you want, is the data. Structure, semi-structure, unstructured. Level one is the semantic, is really adding the semantic views. So semantic views not only defines, you know, what these tables are about, you know, in more precise terms, but what are the metrics, how to compute metrics, how, what are the different aggregation, how these tables relate to each other, such that AI has a simpler view of the schema.
So is that like just metadata about the data?
It's metadata and computation.
Got it.
You know, metrics is computation. For example, if I tell you I'm a financial and I want to compute revenue, how you compute revenue, when you stop, when is the day defined, you know, what do you do with vacation? That is, you know, you need to have this semantic. It's not like a definition of revenue is not the same, depending on the industry, depending on the company. So
that's what you mean by metrics.
Yes, exactly. It's pushing this computation, you know, inside the model such that the AI, when as a human being you ask for revenue over, you know, that time, it knows what to use.
And the advantage there is what? Speed and relevance, right?
It's quality and speed, because you can also optimize the underlying, and we do a lot of the optimization based on, you know, you can metalize, you know, the semantic too.
Okay.
You can pre-build that, because these are obviously oftentimes asked questions, so you can play games like
that. So where are we with semantic views right now? Shipping?
Yes, it ships.
And you feel good about the product?
We're super good, and you know, they are going to evolve, of course. We add, you know, new capabilities, because semantic is, you know, can be complicated, you know, how relationships, but you know, it's a very good, and this is the way the quality of AI has really increased. We are, you know, beyond 95% quality, which is important. We want to get to 100%, don't get me wrong.
Yeah, of course, you got a roadmap.
Yes.
So you're building a roadmap on that. And what's the priority on the roadmap?
The priority is really twofold. One is, as I said, bringing unstructured data to the platform, so how to build connectors with unstructured data, how to, you know, bring all the ACLs, right? It's not only connecting to your SharePoint and bringing that data inside Snowflake, but it's also preserving all the security, and you know, you cannot see all the documents. So we need this layer of governance. I say the data platform is three layers, right? Level zero is data, semantic, and then governance is super important.
Yeah, I'll get the governance in a second. I want to ask about graph databases, because we're seeing the resurgence of graph.
Yes.
Is graph unstructured to you, or is it a different animal for you? How do you view graphs?
No, graph is the relationships, right? It's like everything is graph. If you define, you know, our current life, we are connected, right? We exchange. So this is a connection, so this is a graph. And data, you know, a relational database is a graph, right? You have connection when you join, you know, this is graph relation. Now this this graph can be materialized, right? You have really a pointer to an object, or you have, you know, IDs that you join with, but you need to describe what relation. How do you relate? Yeah. Right, and defining, this is part of the semantic model. It can be materialized, but it can be just defined.
So talk about the third layer. Let's talk about governance, that layer. You got two approaches, Horizon, Polaris. The competition has Unity Catalog.
Competition has two Unity Catalogs. So, the only difference with competition, as you mentioned, is really names. Yeah. We decided that our open source are going to be really a protocol. We want to really bring, the industry around, open source, protocol for catalog, and that was Polaris.
Yeah.
And we have, of course, our Horizon with all the assets that Snowflake has, which goes beyond, tables. As everything in Snowflake, every asset has, is part of the catalog. Even, compute is part of the catalog. So we wanted to have different names, and the competition has two things, a closed catalog, which is Unity, and another one, which is Unity 2, the same name, but it's open source, which is a fraction of what you have in the
Just in call the it Polaris 1, Polaris 2.
So we should have, maybe call it Horizon and Horizon, but we wanted not to deceive. That's the difference. It's just a name. So. Because you cannot, open source everything, right?
Yeah,
because people will not be able to interact with our compute. It doesn't really make sense.
I mean, there's headlines. People like to do the headline grabbing, the competition.
Sure.
We've seen that. The competition always says, dual site Databricks, says that they are faster and less expensive. That was a claim that was made. I mean, you could slice and dice things.
Yes.
How should customers understand what's real and what's not? How would you?
No, this is actually very easy because we do it every day, actually.
Good.
You run, and there are competitive benchmarks. TPC-DS is one of them. You can run them on both platforms, see the performance and compare the price. And I can tell you, this statement is very wrong. You're right. You can say, it's very interesting because there is performance as how efficient you are, and then there is cost, which is a different metric. Price performance is very important.
Yeah.
So we are very competitive, I can tell you.
All right, well, you're very assertive. I like that mojo. And also, the market is confusing. If you could summarize in your mind to a customer, you do this every day, you said, as they plan the generational platforms, because you guys came in, took the market by storm, the data cloud, again, we talked about that at length many times. But now people are looking at a 20-mile stair for their future. They're putting their foundations together, their system architecture, what you're going to call it, from infrastructure, from horsepower. It's a generational decision.
Yes.
How should they think about how they architect it? What are some of the guiding principles you might have to share? Knowing what you know, you got the roadmap, you got the keys to the kingdom. You're the co-founder, you're the product leader. Help me understand what I need to do to set myself up so I don't foreclose my opportunities.
No, it's a very good question. So I would say the most important thing with a platform is, does it support, all my needs? All my data. As I said, all data is super critical. Structure, semi-structure, unstructured data should live under the same roof because you want to join this data together. So that's one. All workload is another one, right? It's not only about analytics, it's transactional. I want to do AI. Yeah. I want to run my application. Running all the things that you need today and tomorrow is a critical part. And then after that, there is the characteristic of the platform. Like if you look at an iPhone and Android, you could say doing the same. It's the same, right? But you have a philosophy in the platform. Snowflake is about simplicity, not taking complexity and not pushing complexity out. Complexity has a lot of cost, has a lot of, you go slow.
Yeah.
So we like to say Snowflake can do more, you can do more with your data with Snowflake.
Yeah.
So that's hard to quantify. It's not, but you can see it, right? Right when you use both products, you will see it.
Yeah, Frank on my team is an Android. He never texts me because he's not on
iMessage.
Actually,
I'm using an Android. I should not have said that as an analogy.
All right, so I have to ask you about Paris because we're here in France. conferences, international conference here. It's very crowded. What's your?
This is great.
Yeah,
I love it. I have to say I love it. I like, you know, I am, you know, still French at heart, and I love, you know, Europe. You know, the energy, creation, innovation.
Yeah.
So it's really good. It's good. Really fun. You know, yeah. When I heard about Raise and I was asked to attend, I say, oh yeah, I want
in Paris.
To be there.
Yes, yes, great wine list here, good food.
I'm coming from the south of France, so okay. You know, Paris, yeah. And
I
like
chill.
The south of France, but
a little chill
but
in
like
the south
Paris
of France.
Too.
Now you're
yeah.
in this big city.
But it's Europe, right? I like to think about Europe.
Benoit, great to have you on, and again, congratulations. And final question for you, as a co-founder, I love companies where founders are still driving the agenda. What's exciting you right now? Obviously, well, competition makes you better, I love that. What's your mind like right now, leaning in to the products? What are you optimizing for? How are you feeling? Share your thoughts.
Yeah, to me, what is super exciting, of course, is AI, but everyone will tell you that answer. So it's not, you know, an amazing answer. But AI, as I said, in my lifetime, I would never have thought that, you know, data platform could bring unstructured data. So this is a huge revolution in my mind, and we are just at the beginning of that revolution. And the other part, which I'm very passionate, I gave this example with iPhone, is direct interaction with the data platform, you know, democratization of access to data. And AI has a huge, you know, role. You can now talk to your data. Any business user can directly use this data platform.
Yeah.
It used to be, you know, only for geeks. Now everyone can use it, and you know, we are working on that, and that's super exciting to me.
Yeah, I have two computer science degrees, and one of them was databases, and I never really talked about the opera. Hey, what do you do? I'm a database person. I mean, you go back in the 90s, it wasn't really fashionable to be like a database. It was very small industry, now it's mainstream.
You're right, you know, I did my PhD in databases, so I was really born in databases, and I love databases because it was both operating system, it had performance, parallelization, it had language, you know, a lot of language in databases, so it's very complete as a science, computer science, so that's what I liked about data.
Yeah, well, congratulations, and again, thanks for coming on theCUBE. It's always great to see you at the summits. Great to spend some time with you personally.
Yes.
Dave Vellante, shout out to Dave's on vacation. Then I get my time. Thanks for coming
That's great.
Appreciate you.
Thanks a lot.
All right.
Okay, bye-bye.
Dageville Zier, the co-founder of Snowflake, one of the first data cloud provider leader in unstructured, structured data, powering the Gen AI and the analytics revolution as data goes mainstream and AI takes over the world. I'm John Furrier, your host. Thanks for watching.